The 2012 film Silver Linings Playbook. This is a very enjoyable movie. I will also say that this one right here is one of the best films from 2012 without question. And recently I did watch it for the first time last year, and going back to rewatch this one, I must admit it is a very enjoyable movie. Two words I have to say about this movie: realistic and relatable. So the story of this one is that a man with a bipolar disorder, he is released from a psychiatric hospital, and so he is determined to win his estranged wife back. And so he meets a young widow named Tiffany Maxwell. Both of them enter a dance competition, but as they train, they become closer to each other and they examine their relationships and as well on how to cope with their situations. And from there, it's a movie I really enjoy. There's so much I like about this one, from the characters, to the music, to the story, to the acting. It all comes together to make quite a movie experience, especially all the praise this movie has gotten over the years. And I must admit, after rewatching this one recently for this review, then it is portraying mental health realistically. And the mere fact that Pat is relatable to a lot of people out there, this is a man that goes through so much. And he is a character that actually finds happiness near the end of this movie, where in the beginning he was struggling to cope with so much that he was dealing with. Overall, when it comes down to it, this is a film I would highly recommend to check out if you've never seen it. The characters in this film, they are very likable to say the least. Like for example, Pat, he's going through a tough time. He's in a fight with his wife because she had cheated on him. And so he finds solace in just trying to understand like the good times. He's going to therapy. And I think Bradley Cooper actually did a good job portraying this character. In fact, it was his role from Rain Crashers that actually got him the role for this film. I always thought that was interesting. And Jennifer Lawrence, she also did an amazing job. She was so good, she actually won an Oscar for Best Actress in a Leading Role. In fact, the chemistry between her and Bradley Cooper is just one of the highlights of this film. And I must also say Robert De Niro, good job as well. And also, can't forget about Chris Tucker, who's playing a friend of Pat. The only complaint I had about his character is that he didn't show up in the movie a whole lot. You know, he had this small role, but other than that, I also think he was just downright good in the scenes that he was in. And it's a movie that looks at mental health as a issue that a lot of people are going through out there. And I must say, when it comes down to it, this film, it is not just energetic fun, but it can teach a lot of important lessons. I'm giving this film an 8 out of 10. You know, it's interesting. There is some bittersweet moments, funny moments, romantic moments. This is a great film to watch. It's still great to look at even more than a decade later. This movie is not boring, not even close to it. But the only negative thing I really have to say about this one is that some characters don't get enough focus on them. And I get it. This is Pat's and Tiffany's story. But if these other characters would have gotten a little bit more character development, then I would appreciate this film just a little bit more. At the end of the day, though, this is just a movie you can sit down and have a good time with. And that is my review of Silver Linings Playbook. Alright, leave your comments down below in the section and let me know what you think about this movie. Okay, this is Slim Guy 172 saying peace out.